Hey, greetings, ladies and gentlemen, businessmen and women all around South Africa, Africa and the world. So I'd like to welcome you to the Thursday Coffee Chat. Today we'll be discussing the branding strategy or the brand strategy. So your presenters for today is myself, Brandon McAlapa, and I'll be with Swarelo, H-Star. So that is me, as you can see, I think. And that is Swarelo there. We'll be presenting the brand strategy. So this chat is brought to you by #BYForce Clothing and TG-Marqeting. To know more about us, #BYForce and TG-Marqeting, just search us on Instagram and on Facebook, even on Google you can. So last week on the coffee chat, we spoke about the branding, where we had five steps of branding or five elements, which go in order categorically. So first one was branding strategy or brand strategy, which was a way to plan the presentation of the business or a way to come about the planning of the business. And the second one was brand identity, which we spoke about when you take whatever that you've planned and make it to be professional so that you can present it to the people. So on the branding strategy, you don't need to show people or sponsors whatever that you've planned. It's for you. It's for on your branding strategy, it's for your brand. How is your brand going to go out? On the brand identity is what it's like an ID card. What do you show people? Then we have the brand tools, things that you're going to use as a brand. Also, we have the brand launch. So after you've planned, you have everything that the professionals can need. What do? You use whatever tool that you have planned, you launch the brand. After launching, you keep the brand moving, which is the maintenance. Because if you don't keep the brand moving, most brands or most companies, they fall after 3 years because they only end at stage four. So that is what we spoke about last week. And then this week, we'll be discussing, as I said, the branding strategy or the brand strategy. And the presenter, I'll hand over to my colleague here, which is Sarella, is the one who will be performing the staff there, giving you more about the brand strategy.
Greetings, guys. My name is Swarelo, as Brandon has already said. I hope you guys are doing very well out there, entrepreneurs, hustlers, and everyone who's watching. So yeah, as Brandon has said, we'll be discussing brand strategy today. Yes, we'll go through a few slides to clearly understand what is this brand strategy. So these are the things that you will need basically for you to have a long-term success. Because in business, you must have you only have a success for 1 week, then after that we start. You must have a success that will last you for a few years or even forever. Yeah. So they are the following. So you'll need to clearly define your brand objectives to your clients or customers, because they will need to know what are you on about, yeah? And you really need to know in brand. So this is, you can see this is a link between branding and marketing, who your customers are, because in marketing you really need to know now who's your customer, where do they live, all those things, how much do they earn a month. So this is a link between brand and, so each and every aspect in business, they connect, right? So the next one, you need to know how does your brand define a long-term success. So the way you define a long-term success will define your, or will contribute to your brand strategy. Then you can look at or now what is this brand strategy that we are talking about. So a brand strategy will consist of the following. What your brand stands for. For example, if you look at Nike, you'll check or now what do they stand for. The basically honor or is the honor a great athletes. That's what they stand for. They never come on TV and sell their sneakers or whatsoever. What they do is that they stand for the honor great client, great athletes, sorry. Also, if you look at Apple, what do? They are about innovation and stuff. So that's what they stand for. They clearly define it to their customers that we stand for 1, 2, and 3. And then, yeah, a brand is a promise. I often say that to many people that a brand is a promise. So you need to promise your customers something. At the end of the day, then you deliver. So a Nike, for example, when you think of Apple, they promised us something. That's why you find some people, they love it. Everything that they use at home, you find the TVs of Apple, everything's of Apple. It is because it is a promise. And whenever they release a new model of iPhone, some people even wait there at the shops because a brand is a promise. They promise them innovation that you'll always get the best interfaces, easy interfaces and stuff at Apple if you check. And you can also check others. Coca-Cola, they promised you what? Greatness in their taste and stuff. So a brand is a promise. You really need to define what promise are you promising to your clients or customers. And the personality that it conveys through marketing, right? If you look at, for example, you can go back to Nike again. So Nike conveys the personality of an athlete, a strong athlete, someone who doesn't give up. Hence their slogan, just do it. So you can see this is, you can clearly see now what personality they are conveying through their marketing. And you can also check many others on now. What personality are they conveying? Some they will convey a personality of, let's see, also Nike, I mean, sorry, Coca-Cola, it conveys a personality of happiness. People are always happy on their marketing, because hence their slogan says, happiness something. So yeah, they make sure they stick to that. Can go to the next section, which is to know how to define your brand and its objectives. So when doing so, you'll need to ask yourself the following questions which you're going to go through. What problem does your brand solve? Again, this thing is a link between marketing and brand, because these things must work together. Yeah. So a brand must solve a few questions. I mean, you must have a problem that you solve. For example, at TG, we can say, if they ask us what problem we're solving, why do we exist? We cannot just exist because we are good at doing that, no. So we are solving a problem of, let's say, people nowadays, you can see things are moving online and everyone wants to see themselves having a space online and they need to have good graphics and stuff. So that's the problem you're solving to young entrepreneurs and startup companies. So you need to have a problem that you solve. In that way, you will communicate it very well through your brand strategy to your customers. And who's your client? So again, this one works hand in hand with the marketing staff. Who is your competition also works with that. What does my brand make my customers feel? For example, you can go back again to Coca-Cola, it makes their customers feel happy. Every time when you can check all the adverts of Coca-Cola, people are always happy. They are always smiling, gatherings and stuff. So that's how it makes them feel. So this one, why do your customers trust you? So this is a promise. That promise that you have kept, you have told your customers, it is the one that it will make them trust you if you keep it, obviously. Like you see companies, you can check few companies like those that have fallen or something. You can check this cell phone company, Nokia. So there's a reason that why Nokia fell. So they had a promise to their customers, but because they failed to keep that promise and they failed to keep delivering, then the customers lost trust in them. So you don't just need to make a promise that with us you will always innovate, we'll always make website that people will interact with. But if you don't keep that thing and people will not trust you anymore. Not people in general, but your customers. And then the story behind your brand. For example, if you look at ByForce, ByForce is a story behind it. It did not just begin and say, I want to make a brand and want to make money and stuff. But no, there's a story that is attached to that. So that makes your customers relate more to your brand. So that they don't just say, we are wearing ByForce or we're wearing Nike. There's a story. I hope Mr. Brandon will go through into one of these good days as these things are continuing. Yes. And then the last point is, yeah, if your brand was a person, for example, we talked about this on the previous section, the personality. So if your brand was a person, how was it going to be like and stuff? How the behavior and everything. So you need to clearly define those things in detail in your brand strategy plan. The next section. So yeah, next week we'll meet same time, same place, same topic. No, not same topic, but same genre. We'll be discussing business as usual. So thank you guys. I hope to see you next week, same time. I'll hand over now to Brandon to conclude. Thank you very much, guys.
Yep. So thank you for joining us today. So next week, as Tarelo have said, we'll be doing the brand identity. So we have done the brand strategy or the branding strategy. So by now, hopefully you should know how to start the strategy of a brand, how you should strategize, looking at the personalities and so forth. So next week we'll be checking how do you present your brand to sponsors or to professionals, because now we're speaking about your own planning of the brand and then also how you take it to the public for the customers and so forth. But next week we'll be looking at the sponsors specifically. How do you get the sponsors? What do they look at when they are looking at your brand? Yeah, so we will be looking at that. So until next week, we are set to say goodbye. Hope you will join us next week. So stay blessed.